Hey, everybody, it's the coach. This is Madden 20 on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see a man on his eighth NFL team, Ryan Fitzpatrick, and the Miami Dolphins as they match up with Andrew Luck and the Indianapolis Colts. I'll see you again with scores and updates at halftime. But for now, it's my distinct pleasure to hand things over to our broadcast team. It's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. Gentlemen.
Okay, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Hoosier State and Lucas Oil Stadium in downtown Indianapolis. Just a short time ago, smoke from the pyrotechnics filled the dome as the Colts made their way out of the locker room. We're set for football as the Colts get set to match up with the Miami Dolphins. Brandon Godden and Charles Davis, thrilled to be with you from the broadcast booth. And partner, before we get this thing started, what are you going to be watching?
Who gets off to a fast start? In horse racing terms, they talk about catching a flyer out of the gate. Who sets the pace and makes the other team chase?
Sanders now to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Andrew Luck now ready to lead this Colts offense. Comeback player of the year in 2018. And for good reason. Remember, he missed the entirety of the previous season in 2017. But he rebounded to throw 39 touchdown passes and lead the Colts to a playoff berth.
Check out. Green 80.
Yeah, that's what I do.
They'll run it here. This is Marlon Mack. A gain of 3, second down. And we look now at the offense for Indianapolis.
It's not often we start a game talking about an offensive lineman, but with Quentin Nelson, I absolutely have to do that. The rookie out of Notre Dame transformed not only an offensive line in 2018, he transformed an offense. In fact, he was the only guard ever named Rookie of the Month, and he did so in October of last year.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Now Luck. Ebron caught left side. They have 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there. And a look at the starters for the Miami defense.
One of the more underrated yet valuable positions in the NFL is safety, and Rashad Jones epitomizes what you're looking for. A guy who can drop down into the box in the run game and tackle those bigger, stronger running backs. He can also cover people, whether it's tight ends or bigger slot guys, and that gives him the ability to stay on the field every down and make big plays.
Throwing on third down, Luck. This goes out right to Doyle, and he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. His first catch, good for 8 and a first down.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Throwing is long. Ebron's got it. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 3. You often say that sort of opens the playbook now, 2nd and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
Not much there. Maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40.
doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. Got an open man. That's Campbell. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
Let's go.
Defense was expecting run, and they're dealt a pass of over 15 yards.
Okay, I'm not so great at math, but I just looked over at our statistician, Marvin, and he signaled to me 5 for 5 to get things started here on this opening drive. Where I come from, that's pretty good.
That is pretty good. Now, what do you do defensively to adjust?
Well, this is where you've got to make a decision as your defensive coordinator. Do you really get after the quarterback? Or maybe you tighten down on the receivers, bump them off of their routes, chip away at their timing so things aren't as precise as they've been so far in this game.
They'll run on first down with Marlon Mack. And a short gain here, down to the 22. Tackle made there by Kiko Alonso.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. It didn't happen on that play.
And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. He lost two there, and it's third down. Now, that screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they had hoped. Is that one they should have even tried, or is that one the quarterback sticks in his pocket?
I think the latter. I like what you said there, because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this case, when you realize it is broken down, just throw it at the feet of your intended receiver so that no one can pick it off, right? You don't have the ball tipped up in the air, and you come back and try and pick up the first down on third down. That way you don't lose any yardage.
Well, this drive, they're a perfect 2 of 2 on third down conversions, but they need a full 10 yards here. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Hines, and he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far in the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
Second quarter now from Indianapolis with the homestanding Colts in possession as they've got it with fourth down and one. We're scoreless after one. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. Look at this, a tight end carry. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. They opt to go for it, and they get it. First and goal after a pickup of 5.
Well, that's what's called being aggressive right there. But I don't know that it's reckless. I think it's much more of a message, hey, defense, I believe in you in case we don't get it. And offense, trying to let him know he believes in him as well.
I like it. Your first drive of the game in plus territory, be aggressive. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of 5. And so far, a very nice, methodical opening drive.
This has the feel of a scripted drive that they rehearsed perfectly all week long, and now they're executing it on game day.
Script looks good so far. A touchdown saving tackle there. Now it's third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this four down territory?
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Colts take it right down and score on the opening drive. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
Vinatieri connecting on the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. That drive, a long one, spanning 15 plays. And the end result was a Marlon Mack touchdown run. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here to lead out the offense in his first year as a Dolphin, but 15th overall, it's the bearded veteran Ryan Fitzpatrick. And the new coaching staff coming in, they finally decided to pull the plug on the Ryan Tannehill era after 7 seasons and no playoff wins. So enter Ryan Fitzpatrick, signed in free agency, fittingly on St. Patrick's Day, by the way. But last year with Tampa Bay, you remember Fitzpatrick got off to that incredible start. Over 400 yards passing in each of the first 3 games of the year, 11 total touchdown passes. And now it's his time to do it with Miami. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. They'll run with Drake. They'll take this from the 40 up to the 45 for a gain of 5.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. He was looking to go back to Stills, and it's 3rd and 5.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. 17 yards for the Dolphins there as they've got themselves a first down.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Now it's a bootleg with Fitzpatrick. Pass incomplete. Albert Wilson, the intended receiver there. But it'll be 2nd down.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Fitzpatrick finding his tight end, Gesicki. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a 3rd down. They had the catch on 2nd down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at 3rd down here. 2 minutes on the clock, 2nd quarter, 7-0 ball game. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. And Wilson has it. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Albert Wilson, 34 yards. And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And a nice job by him to catch the slant and then navigate and break free.
And receivers love slant routes because it gets the ball in their hands so quickly and oftentimes on the move. And when they're on the move like that, then they get to use their best asset, which is usually their speed.
And their speed sometimes, like this instance, can take them into the end zone. Jason Sanders now for the extra point. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So the drive winds up going 75 yards in 7 plays. And it winds up in 6 points for the Dolphins. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look going for Hilton, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kiko Alonso. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. Now, these guys hardly got a chance to catch their breath after the quick turnover, but I doubt they're complaining much.
Especially with the field position they get to start with. I wouldn't be complaining either. I'd want to get right back out there and get after them, because now you have an opportunity to make a big play. I'd say let's be aggressive and go after him.
Throwing Fitzpatrick. It's complete. Stills. A gain of 6 there on first.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it, because you're running away from people on it.
And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend, because you think it's a go route and then he breaks it back on the comeback, but there's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. You have a guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
Now Fitzpatrick. And Stills has got it. Touchdown, Miami. From 6 yards away. And the Dolphins have taken the lead.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Sanders on for the extra point. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Scoring summary, 3-play drive. And it ends with a touchdown for the Dolphins. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This is taken at his 4. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple of extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field.
Inside of a minute left in the half, does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do, or I guess don't do, on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more is who I've got running my football team out on the field and the weapons around him. Can he make a play? Can he get into someone that we're going to trust to take care of the ball? If that's the case, I might push it a little bit here and try and get something before the half runs out.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Taken in by the tight end, Doyle. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. A shotgun snap for Luck. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Now the Colts moving quickly here in the hurry-up offense to try again after the sack. Luck, and that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
The Colts on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This will be a tough 3rd and 18. Out of the gun, Luck. Under pressure and down he goes. Luck is sacked. And they're going to take a timeout defensively. So with fourth down coming up, they go ahead and burn it and say we'll see what happens. And how about this? 4th and long, and they're going to go for it. They are going for it. It's Luck. He's going to look deep down the field. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A 1-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half.